men and women. A woman is like an exotic drink, like a mojito. You'd think you'd be able to see through one, but when you get close to it, you can't. In fact, you can see whatever you want to in there, in the mix of ice cubes and the reflections and the bubbles. You know what's in it. You know all the ingredients, mint, rum, alcohol, sure, what goes into one. But every time you have one, it seems unique, because no two are ever made the same way, exactly. They are cold, but when you take them in, they warm you. If you have more than one of them, you're probably going to get in trouble. They are complex and expensive and hard to find. Beautiful, but generally a pain in the ass. Men, at least in our relationship with women, are simpler. We are consumed by women for the effect. We are harsh. We have a few simple ingredients, the quality of which varies widely, but they are the same ingredients. No one drinks one because they like the taste of them. They like the effect. Now, women dress us up. They try to, chocolate martinis, and strawberry martinis and such, but really, they really still want the martini. And there's a joke about martinis and testicles, which I think applies to how women should relate to men. One is not enough. Three is too many. You see, I think men are simple and women are very complex, and that the laundry list of things women need, and a short list of things any one man can provide. Therefore, I'm not endorsing polyamory, but what I am saying is that women need more than one important man in their life to get everything they need emotionally and physically. And that will create sort of also a dynamic tension between these two men, and that will keep us honest. Ooh, sorry, I didn't mean to say keep us honest. I meant to say make us honest, because we are not naturally honest creatures. You see, men that totally open themselves up and tell women the truth and tell them what they think all the time don't get to reproduce. At least not very often. The gene for total truthfulness does happen once in a while, and we call those people virgins. And they come up to me and say, Lance, I have been wandering the friend zone, which is like the neutral zone between the Klingon Empire and the Federation. It is cold and lonely, and I seek the company of female kind. Please help me, Lance. So I knock the fedora off their head and slip the game controller out of their hands, and I say, son, well, listen up. I say, the three things you've got to do are lie, lie, and lie. When she wants to go to a chick flick, you say yes. When she asks how she looks, you say, you look beautiful. When she asks you to take out the trash, you say, I'd love to, dear. And you know what will happen? Do you know what will happen? Tell me what will happen. Like the Tigris and the Euphrates coming together, her thighs will part. And you will complete your journey, your circle of life. You will return to the delta from which all life springs. And we all know what that is. And you will look into her eyes, and she will make you